Well, hello, and welcome to Garrett Plays With Himself in Hob. Now, this is a bit of a spoiler, this exact moment here, because this is the very last scene of the game. I've already played through and beat the hell out of this game, and it's a ton of fun, but, see, that was my playtime on my previous one, I'm going to start a new one here and go through this fun little adventure with y'all, everybody else. Well, who's there? Hello? Who's knocking at my chamber door? Now, this is a game done by Runic Games. They made Torchlight and Torchlight 2. A majority of the team was part of Diablo. I think it was part of the Diablo 2 team. And then they kind of broke off when Diablo 3, or before Diablo 3 was in development, because they're just like, yeah, we don't really like this. We want to make something a little bit more like Diablo 2. So they went out and made Torchlight, and then, you know, expounded upon that with Torchlight 2. And then they kind of went dark for a while, and they came out with this precious little gem.
Hey, huh?
Where did you go, my giant robot body? And this is, from what I heard, it's kind of like a Zelda game as well. It's a... Oh, these are my save points and also my checkpoints. You can tell from the saving icon in the bottom right corner. And very Zelda-like. It's a top-down isometric view, which is kind of similar to what you found with the Torchlight games, except this is a little bit more zoomed in. But the combat to this is quite a bit more different than Torchlight. Torchlight's a hack and slash, point and click kind of game, where this one is a environmental traversal upgrade kind of system. What's going on? What you doing? Where are we going? What's going on? Ooh, that's some nasty shit. Whoa, god damn, that shit hurts too. That scared me. Well, it's a good thing that I'm only about 2 feet bloody tall. You have taken my head off with that sword there, buddy. You gotta be careful where you're swinging around. And that's something else that's really cool about this game. It's very much like, Dark Souls. Not in the difficulty, but in the way that the environments are connected to one another. You can create shortcuts throughout areas like crazy. It's something where you spend some time getting around to an area, and then you have an ability to smash through a wall or cut down a bush, or you have this blink ability quite a bit later on that allows you to hop between these kind of different platform things and traverse the level that way as well. Just that, and these are not only quick saves, but I believe... No, those aren't the fast travel points. That and the manipulative terrain I find really cool too. And it's something that you have quite a bit of power with, is to change the environment and the terrain, and but you don't gain that ability until a bit of a tragedy occurs. The only thing that's a little bit funky is when they shift perspective on you, or when you're kind of running towards the camera like that, and you kind of, it feels like you have to take a leap of faith, or you have to keep your mouse somewhat straight. Well, not mouse, but I'm using controller here. What you looking at, buddy? Beautiful view over there? Or are you just going to enjoy the scenery? Fine, I'll continue on. Aww. Look at this weird quadruped. You're like a giraffe and an antelope. I'll call you a gelantelope. I think your neck is too thick for your upper body. Your legs don't seem like they would be able to support the weight. That's why giraffes have really long, thin necks, but kind of... Ow! Fucker! I remember the first time that happened. That scared the piss out of me. I was just like, ooh, what the? Help me! Help me, the shit's spreading! No, wait, no, not my left arm! Oh! A game by Patrick Blanks, Ollie Cello, and the guy, Ben Evans, Mike Fisher, and Alan Fong. Now, the one thing that's the most depressing... Oh, my arm! No, aside from losing my arm. Oh, they've got a little bone structure in there, too. Is that... Runic was owned by Secret World Entertainment. It's a Chinese company. And they just shut down this studio. This was the final game to come out by Runic, and they are no more. They're all gone. Hell, I thought that the last patch I was going to see for this game was going to be 1.16.3, but just today, the day of this recording, they came out 1.17.3. What they improved? I'm not too sure, but when I played it, it was about 2 days old. And I played it over the course of a week, and over the course of that week, they came out with about 20 patches. And holy Christ, did this game kind of need it, because, it had some problems. Don't you just hate after a long night, you wake up and you got a giant, muscly robot arm? That would be kind of sweet, except for the, horrible pain that comes with having to lose your real arm, but that and... I imagine you kind of wish that certain other aspects of your body are all buffed up to compensate for it, but... I know. I always thought that Hob was a little robot dude. Just because it kind of made sense. But now, thinking about that, his fleshy arm, the bone in it... how the hell did you meld this robotic, giant, muscly arm onto me, big old bro dude? Then again, I guess I should not complain because, hell, I have a sweet-ass arm now. And I imagine you are a short one because in that cutscene he showed that. So, a little bit of the manipulation of terrain. Now that we have this big old muscly arm, we can move stuff. Can't get through there because that's all filthy. And I think this is an ability I unlock later where I can do a ground pound. And open that up and it becomes a ladder and it's just another shortcut throughout the environments. So things are blocked off. I have to, manipulate the environment. It's a lot of puzzles. That's the one thing I find very impressive and engaging about this game. It's just the constant terrain and manipulating the environment puzzles. Hey, bud. You seem to be missing a left arm. I appreciate your sacrifice. This looks like an ancient ancestor of mine. So ancient that when I take their blade, they disappear. Oh, well. Hey, man, did you see that? You need a hand, buddy? Do you need your hand? I'm short one, too. Well, not anymore, but... I guess that big old muscly arm gives me the ability to do some funky things. Here, instead of having to wander around looking for other pieces of this blade, here they are. That's convenient. Other games would kind of force you to be like, hey, you need to go find these three shards of this blade. And it's like, come on, man. Ain't nobody got time for that. So we walk over to the forge, and we have our little mold for our sword. We drop in one. We drop in two. Ha, ha, ha. And then we put in the third piece. And it kind of reminds me a little bit of Pacific Rim, watching a behind-the-scenes developer diary of making the, the giant Jaegers. And it's all the moving parts that they have to it. I think that was Pacific Rim, or was it Transformers where they're talking about that, where it's just like, we got these 80 or 200 or thousands of little moving segments, and that's what a lot of this game feels like, your sword... when you're not using it, retracts in like three or four different little small segments. And here is our upgrade tree. So we got a sword combo, add a third, more powerful combo attack, a sword thrust, agility. Yeah, there's a dodge roll and all that stuff. Do I have that dodge roll yet? Or yeah, there it is. So very, well, not the stamina meter that you always have to keep an eye on in Dark Souls, but... kind of reminiscent in that, where it's, you get your hits in, you can dodge roll out of the way. I imagine there's quite a few other games out there that have a dodge roll to them, but this one, I don't know, Dark Souls just seems the most poignant in my mind about it. I just love the little touches that they have of whacking away at the grass. Now, this is a fast travel point, but that will open up and unlock quite a bit later. So now that we can bust away at these trees, I'm kind of very curious about the improvements that they've made with the patches, because I haven't played this in quite a few patches. But I, well, imagine that they've solved a few of the little nitpicks and bugs. So there's 10 upgrade orbs. Ooh, well, that was a little janky. Still, it's fine. It works. It's it's fine. It's fine. That, yes. Then we go check out the environment and the world, and I think this kind of shows off little things as well, or it unlocks certain things. Like, what the heck is that little dude there? Oh, yes, it's the foreshadowing. Never really thought about it until it got quite a bit later into the game. You know, what is the purpose? What are we here to do? Why did our big gargantuan buddy open up where we're living and drag us out and be like, hey, come with me? And then, you know, I got infected by the growing masses, the organic, what would you call that? Organic spreading material around the world. And a good leap of faith. Very reminiscent of, not Ratchet and Clank, really. Just the whole leaning, the maneuvering and traversal. Oh, and the, of course, being the development team that made Torchlight, things explode into viscera pretty damn well. Oh, there's a big dude over there. Yes, these are those fast warping points I was talking about. Won't be getting to that till get some sweet upgrades on my arm. So those little wolf children went down without too much trouble, but this big guy, he's gonna take a couple more whacks. What you looking at in here, buddy? You gotta just telegraph their attacks. Oof. You got me with that big swing. That had a bit more range than I expected. But you get back health pretty damn quickly, which is nice. Now with my big old beefy muscly arm, let's see what this guy was trying to access. And just a horrific looking creature too, with the big gangly teeth on the outside. Oh yes. So the autosave is kicked in. Oh Jesus, almost fell to my death there. Whew, good jump. And I love the draw distance too. Like, the environments are just so huge and sprawling. And you head over in a certain direction and you're like, is this the way I should be going? Am I going the wrong direction? You know, you can get down that ladder, won't be able to get back up there. And the game lends itself pretty well to backtracking to different areas as well, which is pretty damn nice. So it's all blocked off, so I guess I was going in the right direction there. Oopsies. And down here, there is fall damage. It's a bit more of a significant fall than that little one there, but there definitely I have suffered many, many, many occasions where fall damage has wiped me out. So we got this big, giant piece of machinery here, and you're like, oh, what in the world could this be? Well, I guess I'll just stick my damn arm in it and find out, right? What's the worst that could happen? It makes sense. I love how it breaks the arm apart into little sections, and then it's just like, well, here's a new piece. Hope you enjoy your upgrade. Weld that in, make sure to connect that, and, well, you may want to test out a few times on a hot dog. You might end up ripping your dick off. And now we got the pile bunker. So, let's go hit something, shall we? Look at that golden sheen, hey? Now I can punch the doors open all on my own. Like a big man. Now that we have the pile bunker, that's the first of the four abilities, I believe, you end up unlocking. A little bit of a leap, a hop, jump. You know, never really spent much time observing the bats. I kind of just ran past and never acknowledged them. They're not an enemy type that you ever have to face, but still pretty neat. And here we are. We've back, well, not backtracked, but created a nice shortcut. Have to wait for the power. That little blue bar is my energy meter for my arm. And if that's, you know, not ready, then I can't do anything. Now, do I have the ability to... Oh, I thought that was an upgrade I had to buy. Never mind. That's something that I just have right off the bat. Fucking A. Okay. Seems that my character got caught up in the environment somewhere. They did a lot of patching. Some things still occur. Games, you know, not 100% perfect, but overall, it's still really... I've never had that happen to me before. I guess I was just standing in a weird spot where something clipped me and blew me out of the environment. Ah, yes, I have a sprint too. Completely forgot about that. Well, at least when you open up shortcuts, they stay open, which is pretty damn convenient. You don't have to redo a bunch of the stuff. I suppose that saves me from having to die in that little weird situation again, but punch that open and it all clipped together. Everything fits together so nicely. You know, I got this weird feeling. Something strange about... I know I can't punch that, but I'm going to try. Just because... out of the, you know, previous game, I didn't perfect it 100%, but I feel I got pretty damn close. So, you know, and it's been a few months. Remembering how to navigate most of the puzzles or the environments may take a try or two. And there, just... I've changed up the terrain. Made this area, you know, slightly different. Can't make that jump anymore. That's why that upper platform was there. It's like, oh, that leads to nothing. Oh, that'll lead to something. It just takes a moment. Hey, bud, I got this sweet-ass upgrade for my arm. What do you think? Oh, man, I wish I had that sweet-ass upgrade for my arm. Now, this was the section that took me a long time to figure out, because I'm like, what do you want me to do? And it's like, hey, go turn on these batteries. And I'm like, well, how the hell do I do that? It's like, I'll head over to that giant area over there, and you'll be able to turn on the batteries. Here's a map. Go over there and do that. Okay, cool. Sounds good. And it has that beautiful kind of, not fog of war, but the undiscovered map that you'd find in... Reminds me of Lands of Lore. Lands of Lore had, you know, you didn't know what was contained in the map until you wandered around and explored and found every little nook and cranny. And yeah. Seems like there was one bug patch that they had done where they, you know, fixed up in, I think it's the electrical area or the water area. Something that I'll get to quite a bit later. Oh, just lounging away, aren't you? You sack of... I'd say bones, but that's not true. Now it's a matter of recognizing and acknowledging what we can interact with, what we can manipulate. Haven't gotten... Wait, how many upgrade orbs do I have? 12. So I think I need 20 to upgrade that one ability. To get my third sword slash. Oh, this might actually give it to me. Hey, what you got? Give me at least 10? And it does give me at least 10. Ask and ye shall receive. It's always good to clean up the dead foliage. Make sure everything's nice and pretty. Yes, and you can kill the animals too. So this brings me right back to the beginning area. Yeah. I need to get that upgrade for improving my energy quicker. Huh. I think there was a certain point of the game where I kind of overlooked or just missed them for quite some time, and then as I was going around trying to, somewhat perfect it, I ended up finding a bunch of stuff that I'm just like, oh man, how did I overlook that for so damn long? Let's see what's up here. That little cavernous part back there, I think I want whatever's in there. Oh, wrong button. Yes, that, the fist, the pile bunker, is a good shield breaker. Yeah. So you get some shielded enemies later on, and it's like, man, how the hell do I break these guys' guard? It's guard breaker. Yeah, shield breaker. That's why it seemed weird when it was coming out of my mouth. Didn't even stand a chance? Aha! Oh! Well, that's what I get for trying to be fancy. Am I gonna die? No, I survived. And you gave me enough health. Oh, Jesus. So you get upgrade orbs from killing dudes. You get upgrade orbs from finding stuff in the environment. Forgot which button was the dodge roll already. Woo! Ooh, Christ. This isn't even the biggest guy that you end up fighting either. It's an even bigger dude. Man, he's tough and mean. So I've kind of completely wandered off the beaten trail. Oh, yeah, that. So it shows you where there are upgrade items throughout the environment. Like the little sword over there is where my upgrade station is. That thing on the left there is a butterfly, and that's something that you don't really get access to until quite a bit into the later game. And all this stuff on the edges can hurt you, which is a damn pain. You have to start reducing back a bunch of the corruption in the area, and you don't really get an opportunity to do that, and that's another upgrade with the arm, I think. Pushing in on that, or that unlocks that door, that's what that does. This was a super fun game. I'm happy to be playing it again, and I hope you enjoy going through this experience with me. So, man, it's just super pretty. Lack of localization, I suppose you could call it. Oh, I remember what's down there. I don't want to face that right now. Big troll dude. And I am in no condition right now to be dealing with a troll dude. Oh, sorry, little dude. I didn't mean to kill you. Nah, I need to get more upgrade orbs and stuff before I start taking that on. Or at least hit a bit of a save point, just in case I... That changes into something else, too. Where am I? I have not made too much significant progress in the direction in which I was, told to go. But I'll get there in time. Oh, yes. Sword upgrade. Sweet. Two more of those, and I'll be able to get my level 2 sword. And there, I think... can get the sword up to level 4, and the design on it changes and looks pretty damn sweet every time too. Can I traverse up this? I think I can. It's a matter of whether I can make these jumps. He's good at grabbing ledges too. I enjoy that. Okay, so line jump almost. Oh, I don't have the upgrade to use this quite yet. So there are certain sections that are just completely blocked off that you can't get to until you have certain powers. And that is one of them. Took me a long time of wandering around where I'm like, man, how the hell do I get in there? And I'm like, hey, how about if I just climb up these rocks? Oh, I thought you bastards were one hits. Come on, you filthy animals. Give me some upgrade points as well while you're dying for me. Can't even do that. Useless. Mangy mongrels. And then there's larger variants of those, and I think, yeah, there's just the small ones, and then there's, well, these are the small ones, and then there's slightly larger ones, and that's it. Yeah, I think those are the most dangerous. Knock, knock. Who's there? Oh, yeah. I believe there is an upgrade a bit later on where, well, you get multiple charges for that, which is very convenient. But also, yeah, that area just to the left is where that little jump pad would bring you to. Also, I think recharge rate has improved, too. Quite a few good crystals here, or upgrades. Another little cave. Might give me something nice. And this is a health upgrade, but only half of it. So, kind of like in Zelda, you have to get two or three of these before you can upgrade your health fully. It's the heart containers. We're not doing the three heart challenge. Oh no, screw that. Yeah, I guess this is quite a bit like Zelda. Where it gives you the three heart containers. So that opened up a nice shortcut back to that large central area. Which would get me through there, but since I'm right here, I might as well go through this little dungeon. Oh, it's not a dungeon. It's, more upgrade materials. Sweet. That should bring me up to, like, 70 now. No, it's not even that. It is a schematic. So, the sprite cloak boosts speed but reduces health and energy. So this is a different type of cloak I could equip that gives me those, well, they have their benefits and their drawbacks all in the same. Do I want to fall down there? It's a quick run back to the upgrade. Well, I do have the ladder. Actually, I know where there's another heart container. How much running can I do before it depletes my blue bar of energy? Well, I guess I can just run forever. Sweet. Because right back at the beginning area, where, you know, I came out of my little hovel, there's a heart container hidden back there, so that could get me up to four hearts, or four health, which is good. So this is where I started, but there's nothing in there. There's a door over to the right over here, which I can't do anything with right now. And I think it's over to the left where that container is. And I can't get up there either anymore. Well, there's one which teleports you around, like arm upgrades. There's the one that allows you to punch shit, the Paul Bunker. Then there is another one that allows you with a little grappling hook, which is pretty damn convenient. There we go, that's that other hard upgrade. So that gets me up to four right off the bat. And then if you're looking, you can see that I need like six pips to be able to get my stamina meter. I guess it's something you can't buy, but... And then they have beautiful little silhouettes like this, where animals in the far distance run at 5 frames a second. Just because. You know, draw distance. It would be less distracting if you actually didn't have the animals running at a super low frame rate. That or... Just for that situation, lock it off so you, I don't know, you can max out the frame rate on the creatures in the far distance. Oh, hey. So, if I hit this, this is going to change the environment here. And, all right, I want to get up. Ah. How the hell do I get up there again? I think I have to go wide way around here. I'm gonna spend a bunch of time just messing with little things here and there before I even get to the mission at hand. It's like, hey, man, go do this stuff. It's like, yeah. I'll get to it. There. So instead of having to do that whole big runaround, now I have that nice little ladder there. That saves me some time. So what did I change with this? I don't think anything significant. And I don't know if I can change it. Oh, yeah. It gave me access to get to this, but I don't have the proper ability to use that right now. So, let's get back into it. Enough of this dilly-dallying. Dilly-dally, shilly-shally. Alright, so... up and to the right? So I get back to where I want to be? Or at least back on the right track? No, this still doesn't... Oh, yeah, this is something new. Gotta watch out for those. They will hit you hard. I think they'll take off a whole pip of health, too, when they hit you, those damn spiky arms. There are some areas where it's just like a gauntlet running through those. It's pretty terrifying. It's like, oh, gotta keep running, car, keep moving. Nope, it was worth a try. Couldn't remember. Come on now, jump up. Oh. Yeah, I guess I don't need to take the long way because I punched through that wall. And we're just at that point where I was looking at those, well, what I call them? Giraffe eagles? No. Gazelle giraffes? Where they were moving at such a low frame rate, so it went from that, well, distance over there and moved all the way up there in pretty relatively quick time. So, I am not buying the sprite cloak. Improved rolling, summon a shield. Oh yeah, the shield is super convenient. Just a matter of how much I remember to use the damn shield. Yeah, I believe that is B.